What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the JOAT homestead. So what I got here is my evaporative cooler. So I'm pretty excited for this. Home Depot had something in stock. Home Depot is right next to my house, so it's a little bit easier for me just to go there. But they had something in stock. This is a little bit oversized, but it's a window unit. I'll show it to you a little bit more when I unbox it, but it has everything in it, so I don't need to buy the motor or the pump or any of that stuff. It's basically an all-in-one unit. I do want to see if it has the little hose bib. I bought it separately just in case it's not in there, but it does say it has an installation kit, so maybe that's in there. But we'll get it onto, I made a little assembly here, so I can get it up next to the window. I'll show you that in a second. So we'll get it up onto my little ramp here, or my little workhorse area. And then from there, we can slide it up closer to the window. We'll have to take some measurements to build the stand for it to sit on. But it's a pretty heavy system, or a pretty heavy unit. So I do have a few pallets in the truck, or in the trailer bed. That helps with like loading stuff in and out. So I just gotta lift it up a little bit, and then I can slide it up closer to the window, unbox it, take some measurements, and build a platform. So for now, I'll get this up onto the up onto my work area. Trying to use that piece of plywood to help support it. This front side doesn't have a lot of support, and these two beams are a little bit wider than the unit. Probably good there. The unit's over that sawhorse, so we'll unbox it there. It'll have to turn 90 degrees to get installed, but I'll leave it there until the platform's built. So I'm going to unbox it, and then I might get a couple 2x4s just to put underneath there to give it a better place to sit while I unbox it. When I do those straps, I feel like it's going to move around. Have hanging brackets, but I'm going to build a stand for it. Pumps there. It's missing two of the clips. So inside there's a little retaining clips. Let's go ahead and change your angle. I'll bring you guys in a little bit closer. I'll zoom you in.
one or the other. Let's take a look.
Little water drops, water tubes for the from the pump. The pump is on the backside. It pumps it up, and then there's like six tubes, two for each side. So it's missing a clip over here. There's like a little black clip there that holds the tube in place. It's missing one here, and it's missing one over on that side as well. We'll see if there's any spares in the bag, but.
Legs might be fine. We'll see. Maybe I'll put a temporary stand underneath and we'll do a permanent hook and legs. Okay. So you have to, if you're gonna do the hook and legs, take off those two screws and install that in its place. I may go ahead and do that anyway, just in case I use that. It's already a little bit loose. Three-quarter inch drop. With 3 pounds of pressure. I have other systems that are like that as well. What is this way? This model is the RWC50. It's their bigger system, 155 pounds. Oh, dry with water in it, 250 pounds. It's quite a bit of weight. Yep. Half horsepower motor. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty wild. Oh, you could do vertical installation, that's interesting. Okay, pretty straightforward. Nothing else in here that's really worthwhile noting. Oh yeah, I do want to see what those little black pieces are. That's probably. Yeah. Okay. Those are part of the window flush out kit. Okay. Thinking about some logistics. Yeah, if I would have known how they recommend the install, I just would have had this set up right in front of the window.
Yeah, that's all good.
I'll probably just get another set of sawhorses. They're a little bit smaller duty, but I'll set them up over there. They don't have height adjustments like these ones do, but I think it'll still, I could put some platform stuff on there. That'll get me pretty close. Provide you a little bit of shade. Okay, so need to put the anchor bolts up top. Let me double check the width of this. I want to get those kind of straight in line. The hook points for the chains are right there. That's the hole for the hook points for the chains. So the chains basically go on the outside up, and then the dowel rods here push against the house at the bottom. So that holds it away from the house, and then the chain holds it up. And then this holds it from going down. So this keeps it from just slipping out. So you kind of have to get it into the window, this holding it up, and then this sets it how far away from the house you need it, and the chains hold it up. So it's pretty clean. I think it's sturdy enough. A lot of the weight is going to be held on here, and then the chains, but I think that's fine. There's about 10 and a quarter between the lip and the back. So that'll go in the window. Say 33 and a half there. Alright, I'll leave you guys there for now. I just gotta move, there's a hose reel over here, a garden hose reel that I'm taking off. It's gonna be in the way. And also my cat perch is out here. So the cat door will move somewhere else. So I'll take out the little cat perch. I'll make a new entrance from the top of this. The cat can jump up here. And I'll make another entrance for the cat up above it. Oh yeah, I gotta lift it up quite a bit anyway.
Actually not too far, just a little bit.
But I'll probably need to go in the house to finish opening up the rest of the window, take out that cat door. So we'll do that.
That's a lot of water.
Yeah, we'll see. Actually, I can take this sawhorse out because these are supported on the trailer. Most of that weight's on that sawhorse anyway, so we'll get a little risky, a little more efficient. These sawhorses are really nice. They allow it to drop down. Put a couple 2x4s in here and screw them in, so that way I have like a little bit of a work table here. That, or I just get some more of my planks, extend the planks over. That's probably a better idea. Just like that. That'll work. That'll work. Think if you think about the idea for a little bit, there's always a more efficient or a little bit better way to do it, so. Yeah. That'll work. Grab one more plank for over there. That way I can shuffle it around without it falling. Thank you. pause to think first.
Work smart, not hard.
As fast as I want to get this done, it's going to be better to get those lag bolts up there first. Stand on here. Let me go grab a drill, make sure I'm tapping into the studs. I'm gonna drill a bit.
We'll actually pause you there. I'm gonna go ahead and get that window open while I'm inside. Alright, so we got the window open back up. As you can see over there, so that's open and ready. So now we'll get the carriage bolts and put up above the window. So we'll drill a hole, make sure I'm getting into the actual stud, and we'll go from there. And we'll go from there.
There we go, that's the main support. That's the main support. Well, let's check here.
Yeah,
I should be fine there. Thank you.
I need to get a little bit of support behind it. I need to get a little bit of support behind it so I can tilt it up to get it into the window. It's about 4 inches, maybe 6 inches. So I just gotta tilt it back a bit as I push it forward. The better way to do it is to lift up the front and put some more stuff underneath the front to lift it up. So I'll probably do that instead. Thank you.
pretty much there.
The biggest thing of this strategy is this is a very thin board, so it can just fall over easily. So I have to hold it in place as I kind of slide it forward. But we're now like quite a few inches into the window, so might be good from here. And that board just fell over, so pretty much there. From here, I'll probably go inside to lift it up. I think it's gonna be easier to pull it up inside, get it into that lip of the window. So I'll keep the camera rolling. So pretty much all the way up forward, just got to center it and then lift it up and hook the chains. What I'll probably do is do one chain at a time and kind of lift it up on one side and then lift up the other side. And then I'm also going to push those rods out at the same time. Another idea I have is bringing my jack out here and using the jack with a piece of wood to lift it up. But we'll see, I might just see if I can get this up on my own. The hardest part's gonna be getting the chain on the hook, but we'll see. I need to get better leverage. Like, I need to be taller up, so I might grab a step stool, a little step ladder. So we'll grab a step ladder. Thank you. be up too high. We'll see. Get those rods adjusted up in the front, and then we'll pull out the level to check for level. It looks like the battery's dying, so let's see how much time is left. There's only 3 minutes there, so it's pretty straightforward. Maybe I'll do a quick wrap up at the end. But I'll finish getting it leveled. You know, that's basically most of the install. Just got to push the rods out and then fine tune a level on it. Make sure it's level. That way the water in there doesn't spill out the side and it spills out the overflow valve. But yeah, maybe another 30 minutes to an hour I'll have this up and running. I also bought, it doesn't include the hose bib. So I'll grab that real quick to show you. I mostly bought this one just because it had both the pieces in there. They didn't really have the proper two pieces together in the same package. I could have went with plastic, but I don't really need this much copper. But it's all the pieces I need in one package, so I didn't have to go try to look around or go to a different store to get the right pieces. So this will work. But this just goes on my outside hose, which is basically right below the unit. And there's compression fitting there for the copper pipe. And then, as you saw earlier, there's a little float valve. And then it looks like there's also an overflow valve, so I can hook up a drain hose, or here, it's perfectly fine. If it just drains right here, it'll go to my driveway if it overflows, if the float valve malfunctions. But that's basically it. So maybe I'll do a final picture of it running, but thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.